Is Mohammed mentioned in the Bible? Perhaps he's mentioned in Isaiah 29:12. Well, let's take a careful, honest look. Isaiah 29:12 says, "And the book is delivered to him that is not learned, saying, Read this, I pray thee. And he saith, I am not learned." That is what it says. You can go look it up yourself. Some want to see, "And the book is delivered to Mohammed, saying, Read this, I pray thee. And he saith, I am not learned." Why? Why do they see it that way? Well, Mohammed was unlearned. But is that a valid way to interpret the Word of God? Let's look at the context to figure it out. Woe to Ariel the city where David dwelt. Add you year to year, let them kill sacrifices. Yet I will distress Ariel, and there shall be heaviness and sorrow, and it shall be unto me as Ariel. And I will camp against thee round about, and lay siege against thee with a mount, and I will raise forts against thee. And thou shalt be brought down, and thou shalt speak out of the ground, and thy speech shall be low out of the dust, and thy voice shall be as of one that has a familiar spirit out of the ground, and thy speech shall whisper out of the dust." Think about it. Is this a happy blessing? Is this an announcement of praise? Is this a good tiding? No, this is a woeful speech, a curse. "Moreover, the multitude of thy strangers shall be like small dust, and the multitude of the terrible ones shall be as chaff that passes away. Yea, it shall be an instant, suddenly. Thou shalt be visited of the Lord of hosts with thunder and with earthquake and great noise and storm and tempest and the flame of devouring fire. And the multitudes of all the nations that fight against Ariel, even all that fight against her and her munition and that distress her, shall be as a dream of a night vision." It's going to be a nightmare attacking Ariel. "It shall even be as when a hungry man dreams, and behold, he eateth, and when he awakes, his soul is empty. And as when a thirsty man dreams, and behold, he drinks, and when he awakes, and behold, he is faint, and his soul has appetite. So shall the multitude of all the nations be that fight against Mount Zion." It's going to be a nightmare, a dream that doesn't end. It's not going to be satisfying. "Stay yourselves and wonder, cry out and cry. They are drunken, but not with wine. They stagger, but not with strong drink." It is going to be completely overwhelming. "For the Lord has poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep, and has closed your eyes, the prophets and your rulers. The seers has he covered. They are not going to know what to do. And the vision of all is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed, which men deliver to one that is learned, saying, Read this, I pray thee. And he will say, I cannot, for it is sealed. And the book is delivered to him that is not learned, saying, Read this, I pray thee. And he saith, I am not learned." Look at 11 and 12 again. What is this even talking about? "And the vision of all is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed." Your vision, your understanding, Ariel, is going to be like a closed book. Verse 11 says, "It was delivered to one that is learned, saying, Read this, I pray thee. And he said, I cannot, for it is sealed." It is a closed book. Verse 12 says, "Delivered to him that is not learned, saying, Read this, I pray thee. And he saith, I am not learned." It is a closed book. So it does not matter if you can read or cannot read. It is a closed book. That is what the Lord is saying here. He is saying your vision is blind. You have no vision. You have no understanding. It doesn't matter if you can read or cannot read. It will be as a closed book. Is this talking about an unlearned prophet? No, it is not. Does 29:12 even fit the Islamic description of Muhammad receiving the Quran? What is the Islamic description? Who gave the book to Muhammad to read? The angel Jibril, or Gabriel. That's what Islam claims, and that's what they're trying to say exactly matches this depiction in Isaiah 29:12. But in Isaiah 29:12, who delivered the book? In verse 11, men delivered the book. In verse 12, also men delivered the book. It is like men giving the book to one who can read, and men giving the book to one who cannot read. There's no mention of an angel here, so it does not even fit. So does 29:12 even fit the Islamic description? No, it does not. Could Isaiah 29:12 be referring to Muhammad? No, it cannot. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.